So, Mr. Sharp, in India is hemp something different like in Slovenia. Yeah, you don't have forbidden or something like this, but
No, it
you
is.
must start it with new stuff.
Correct. So I will cover that in my presentation. So good morning, everyone, and namaste and warm greetings from India. I would like to thank Myra for inviting me here, and it's been a week since I've come to Slovenia. It's been a wonderful experience. So to give you a little introduction about myself, I'm Sumit Shah. I'm a founder and director at Birmingham Company. We're India's first organization working along with the government to develop the entire hemp and cannabis industry in India. So through the course of my presentation, I'll be giving you insights into how we are working with cannabis as a tool to bring about socio-economic change in rural India's farmer community. So I'll be giving you insights into how we are functioning with the ecosystem, a little history of cannabis in India, and also, of course, the laws and what regulations we are working with. So how many of you all have over here been to India? Superb. I hope you all have been to the Himalayas, because that's where you find a lot of cannabis growing. So most of this cannabis is grown wild. Because it's grown wild, they call it the motherland of cannabis, because there are mixed breeds of various sativa, indica, ruderalis. So that's why, if you really want to look for unique strains, unique varieties, that's the place to go. So for those who haven't been to India, this is India. It's a large country in South Asia. We are the seventh largest country by area and by GDP, and the second most populous country with 1.2 billion. So the cannabis germplasm is known to have its origin in the Central Asian background, and it's been in India since 2000 BC. So in fact, this is one of our scriptures. It's a very ancient scriptures called the Vedas, and they mention cannabis and the use of cannabis in great detail. And these scriptures have been known to be written around 1500 BC. So it's part of our culture since a very early age, and even today, a lot of people use cannabis and hemp as a whole. Cannabis is described to be one of the number of herbs that release you from anxiety, and that's why it's used in Ayurveda, which is an ancient system of medicine. So one of the first documented evidence of the hemp industry in India was actually by the British. So India was a British colony for around 200 years, and at that point of time, they conducted a large-scale study, primarily to see if India was in a position to supply large amounts of hemp for British Royal Navy and the Army. They even had a study that says that if they were looking at prohibiting cannabis, the production of and the distribution of cannabis. But eventually, they came to know that it's in our culture, and it's something that you can't really work with, and you go against the population. So moving on, when we traveled a lot because of when we were exploring the scope of cannabis in India, we traveled through Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, and Uttarakhand. They are primarily the hilly mountainous regions, and those are the same regions the study before this mentioned that grows a lot of cannabis. So over there, we found that people have always been using this crop. They use the entire plant. So they use the fiber for winter jackets. They use the seeds as spices in their food. They use the resin as local medicine. So for generations, the art of using the entire plant has been passed down from household to household. And however, the hemp industry in India as a very structured and organized industry is very chaotic. Even the government recognizes the fact that the primary reason the industry is not developing is due to the lack of clarity and the lack of private players. There is a lack of supply, quality supply for people in the private industries to take up and use and make further products. So that brings me to my organization, Bombay Hemp Company. I'm one of seven co-founders at Bombay Hemp Company, and we are known as Bohiko. So our story began something like this. We all studied in the same college, some of us in the same class. In college, we were working on this social enterprise, which provided electricity, solar electricity to rural areas. So when we were traveling through the rural areas, we actually saw and witnessed the problems of Indian agriculture firsthand.
we came to know that the problems are far fundamental and deep-rooted. It's not something that, you know, technology can easily solve. And similarly, at that point of time, a co-founder of Mike Jahan happened to visit Australia. So over there, he saw a flourishing hemp industry. So that brought back the idea to us. And it struck us that, you know, a crop like hemp can be the perfect solution for the agrarian economy of India. So that's why in January of 2013, we formally set up a company, and we've been working on developing the industry ever since. Our vision is very clear: to be the world's pioneering hemp enterprise through valuable, sustainable, innovative, and impactful models, products, and services for society and environment. So there are two primary divisions or sections of our company. We have the commercial division and the trading division, or the fundamental science and the research division. So the fundamental science division is looking at growing this crop at mass scale in India and creating products in India. So we have tied up with India's foremost government research firm to develop the low narcotic seed, because that forms the basis of the industry. Last harvest season, we carried out a nationwide activity where we went across the nation to figure out what cannabis grows where. So we collected 81 unique varieties or unique germplasm from various geographical locations, climatic conditions across the nation. So we are also working on varieties for seed, varieties for fiber, and medicinal varieties along with this government institution. On the commercial front, Bohico is developing a strong global and domestic market. We've collaborated with various companies like Hemp Foods Australia, Hemp and Honey Plus from America to import their products and distribute them in India to create a market. We also set up a textile division that not only deals with power loom fabric, but also Indian indigenous handloom fabric. This is all woven by hand. And the shirt I'm wearing is a 100% hemp shirt manufactured in India. We've launched an in-house brand called THC, that's the Hemp Couture, and we're working on products like apparels, shoes, bags, and other accessories. So, we being students of business have learned at an early age that if you want to go fast, you go alone. But if you want to walk far, then you walk together. That's one key philosophy we work with at Bombay Hemp Company. So, to give you an example of this collaborative model, we've partnered with India's premier design school, the National Institute of Design, to develop a platform that's India's first dedicated center for natural fibers. That's the Innovation Center for Natural Fibers. This platform is to link industry and to link the academic institutes, because a lot of times we've seen there's a great mismatch between what the academic institutes are researching on and what the industry actually needs for developing its products. We lead the group for Himalayan fibers like hemp and nettle over here. So this led us to adopt a cooperative in the Himalayan state, mountainous region. This small cooperative of 25 farmers and artisans make hand-spun fabric. So they used to make hemp blends with wool, with cotton, and Himalayan nettle, which is another natural fiber. The entire process of converting the stock into finished products was manually done. So they used to water at it, they used to heat the fabric and cook it, manually decorticate it. This entire process was time consuming and inefficient. So we, along with a few of our knowledge partners, came together and helped them mechanize the process. So we brought about a small decortication facility to them, and now they are not only working on fabrics, but they are also developing bags, belts, shoes. So we're looking at further product development. And this is also going to be launched under our brand of THC. So the hemp crop, as you would know, has around 10,000 users or more than that. And it would be impossible for us to work with all of these fabrics, all of these products. So that's where we set up Bohico Innovation Lab. So where any individual who has an idea, be it scientific or commercial application of cannabis, can join hands with us and make that a reality. So it is this platform that enables us to work with products that we've not even thought of. We have been working on projects like making low-cost biodegradable sanitary napkins for the rural community. Because there are a lot of startups in India, especially from the engineering colleges, which want to work with newer materials and look at different ways and different solutions for rural India. And this is a perfect platform with which we can collaborate and work with newer people. So the hemp and cannabis industry in India is still at a very nascent stage. That's why Mohico has decided to position itself right in the center of this ecosystem. We've realized early on that in India, we're not only building a company, but we're also building the ecosystem. We have to contribute and help support the entire industry. Hence, right at the apex is the global companies and countries. Because we are in a unique position of starting from scratch, we can modify and change the industry to ensure that we work in a fair manner. We learned from countries like Australia and Canada, which recently opened up the hemp economy, and use their guidelines to work on our legislation. We also work with companies like Hemp Foods Australia, the global hemp group from Canada, to help develop the Indian economy as a whole. So in order to prove a new concept, we believe that the best approach is to take an evidence-based approach. So that's why we work with Indians and global scientists on multiple projects on every level of this ecosystem. So we are working on low THC seeds, we're working on standard operating procedure, standard cultivating procedure, low-cost harvesting and sowing machines or post-processing machines, and also end products. So the Indian institutes have shown great interest in the research of hemp and cannabis. So in the last 5 years, we've had 41 papers published, right from cannabinoids for anti-cancer activities to cannabis sativa for alternative pulp, wood pulp. The primary hurdle these researchers were facing was the lack of material. Now, with Bombay Hemp Company and the Mohico Innovation Lab, we are in a position to supply them with a lot more material, and this will ensure that a lot more research is done in the future. Now for the part that everyone would be curious to know. What is the legal status of hemp in India? So the government has had a very progressive framework set in 1985. They passed this act called the Narcotic Drugs and the Psychotropics Act. This is the NDPS Act. And it's under this act that governs the cultivation, the processing, and the commercialization of industrial hemp and cannabis. So with respect to industrial hemp, there exists a special provision relating to cannabis. It mentions that the government, by special or a general order, may permit the cultivation of industrial hemp seeds for horticulture purposes. Upon working with the central and state government policy makers, Mohico, together with the Government Institute, has received India's first license for the research and development of industrial hemp seeds. Similarly, the NDPS Act also empowers the state government to license the cultivation of hemp or cannabis for medical purposes. We've been actively working with the relevant state bodies, be it the Excise Department, the Agriculture Department, Health Department, or the Narcotic Department, to frame the guidelines and develop the licensing system for this medicine. The government also recognizes the fact that foreign companies, the global companies, would like to invest in India to make use of this budding opportunity. So that's why they had already set up a program called Make in India, where the government assists companies with single window clearance, with easy financing, and other such facilities. There are certain states in India which will give you further subsidies or land banks for setting up an agro-processing unit in the country. So, we're now going to the farmers. India has always been an agrarian economy, with around 50% of its workforce and in agriculture and agriculture-allied activities. We have close to 395 million acres of agriculture land. So we are the highest producers of milk and vegetables. We are the second largest producers of food, so that's wheat and rice. This makes a crop like hemp very interesting for the Indian economy, because half of our land is in the equatorial zone, so we get a good average day length. That's why the Indian farmers are fairly excited about this. We've received queries in tunes to 15,000 acres already from 700 odd farmers, small, medium and large farmers. So in India, keeping in mind the fact that most of the farmers are small, have small and marginal land holdings, we've adopted a very unique model for the farmer community. We work with a farmer cooperative or producer group system where we set up a farmer cooperative which has the machines, which is the center point for the cultivation and collection activities. So this empowers the farmer, it creates a sense of ownership among the farmers and helps them progress in the social scale. Now, moving on to industry. So there's one thing that's unique about the hemp industry. Hemp is a resource. It has to be accepted by any industry and adopted into its products. It can't be only used up by itself. So that's why we work with industry leaders and their already existing ecosystem. We don't want to set up a new factory or new line altogether. We go to an industry leader who's got good R&D facilities and use his own ecosystem to make end products. Yep. So that's when we realized, and this is one thing we absolutely believe in, is the necessity is the mother of all invention. So in India, we call this jugaad, or frugal innovation. So to give you an example of this, we were looking at decortication methods. So this machine you see is used by farmers to decorticate green jute stalks. What we did was we changed and modified the machine a bit, and we achieved around 70 to 80% decortication of dry hemp stalks. So this allowed us to use a stopgap mechanism, and it's fairly cheap also. So for the farmers, till the time we developed the best decortication of, machine available, this is the best, this is the easier and a cheaper way of doing decortication. We're also working with Indian business houses and learning from them some best practices. Because we are a young startup, the environment in India, for the entire ecosystem in India for startups is very good. A lot of people recognize the fact that there are newer industries that need to grow for the Indian economy to boost. And they are ready to support this, be it financially or with the resources or with information. Consumers is in fact the most important part of this entire ecosystem. Because whatever product you make, eventually has to be sold. You have to make the your product according to consumer specification. So this, because India has a very robust economy, it enables us to research and commercialize almost any kind of product consumer needs. And this, our aim is to be the center point of any hemp related demand for the world. So I would like to end with by saying is that we don't want to reinvent the wheel. We believe that the hemp economy across the world is fairly young, and that we have a long way to go to ensure that we have sustainable products, better products in the market. So that's why if I would like to invite all of you all to India, if you all have an idea, a project that you all would like to implement, do get in touch with us, and we'd like to see where this goes forward. Thank you.